Okay, everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is a countdown video to my top 15 plus 3 honorable mentions of villain figures. Villain meaning villains from different movies, stuff like that. Most, they're all from movies, not really any TV shows. I think I only have one villain from a TV show, unless you count, like, the Batman animated series. But other than that, I think I have one villain from a TV show, and that's the Governor. But he's not in this list. From The Walking Dead, but he's not in this list. So, just before I do want to say, I am taking requests for videos. You know, I kind of ran out of ideas here and there, and I'll be putting up a video later for requests. So if you have any requests for, you know, I mostly reviewed most of my figures I have, but if you have any, you know, cool ideas for, you know, videos and stuff, or want to see an updated review on a figure I maybe did a while ago, just let me know, and I'll try to get that video for you, so, because if I don't have requests, videos are very limited, so, we will get started, really fast now. The figures vary, you know, are various from Disney, horror, Lord of the Rings, Star Wars, and stuff like that. So, I just decided to use this video because, you know, the villains are awesome in movies. And so, yeah, so number 15 is this Cruella de Vil figure. It was from McDonald's back in the 90s sometime. And, I always loved this figure. I think the detail for a Happy Meal toy on her is very nicely done. She looks great. She has some articulation, not much though, but actually pretty good articulation for a McDonald's toy. And I just always loved this figure. And I love Cruella de Vil. And big thumbs up to her coming to Once Upon a Time next year. Number 14 is this PVC Evil Queen figure. This Evil Queen figure obviously doesn't have any articulation, but I think she's still pretty cool because she was in one of the first Snow White box sets I got, and I think the detail on her is pretty nicely done. The likeness is okay, but it's still pretty nicely done, and yeah. Number 13 is this another Happy Meal toy, and it's Scar. I think this is another one of my favorite Happy Meal toys I have, and I really like the detail. Again, the detail for toy is pretty nicely done. He looks just like him from the movie. It's just really nicely detailed. Number 12 is a bigger figure. And it is from Applause, and it is my photo figure from Hunchback of Notre Dame. He's pretty cool. I think the detail on him is pretty nicely done, really nicely textured. I think the face sculpt is pretty good. Got a fabric sash here. So yeah, he is number 12. Number 11 is a newer figure I recently got, and it is this Maleficent figure that I got in a Sleeping Beauty set. I really like the sculpt of this figure. The color is a little off, but I really like the sculpt, and of course the long, you know, flowing cloak. I really love that effect on figures, and I actually like that you can take her staff out. It's pretty cool. I do kind of wish her staff was, you know, a little bit more painted, but of course, if you have the figure, you can do that yourself. And she also comes with her pet Raven, which I will try my best to put on. He doesn't like to stay on all the way sometimes, but overall, I think this is a really cool Maleficent figure. So, but there he is. Number 10 is the Vintage, the Episode 1, 1999, Star Wars Darth Sidious. You know, you're probably wondering why I picked this Darth Sidious. This is definitely one of my favorite Palpatine figures. Pretty much for, you know, just because I got him a while, you know, 1 year for Christmas. I just love the overall look of this figure. You know, his articulation is very limited, but it's still a very good figure. Again, love the dragging effect on the cloak. So, he's a pretty good figure. What number are we on? Number 9, I want to say, is another Evil Queen figure. And this one is from the Japan Tommy line. And I like this one a lot. She only has one point of articulation, that is a swivel head. But the detail on her is pretty nice. And they pretty much got the color of her outfit pretty much just right. And again, the dragging effect, love that. Pretty cool, but one of the reasons, but the likeness doesn't look too much like her, but it's still, you know, not bad, but one of the reasons I really like this figure is because of her accessory she comes with. She comes with this cool mirror accessory. It's an actual mirror, as you can see. I think it's really cool. And, you know, it comes with a stand that, you know, it can stand up by itself. That way you don't have to lean it up against anything. So, I think that's really cool. And that they actually made a magic mirror for, you know, a figure size. And you can, you know, use it for any Evil Queen figure if you have any. This one, I think this one looks really good looking at it. Or you can even take Maleficent and use it. That's funny though. So there is that one. This number 9, I want to say, the Dark Knight movie Masters Joker, the first release, I think this one is. I know there were two versions released. I'm not sure which one I have, but I love Heath Ledger's Joker. He's the best Joker to me, in my opinion. But all the Jokers are really great. Joker is my favorite Batman villain overall. But the figure, I love this figure, and it's very nicely detailed. I think the face sculpt is a pretty good likeness, in my opinion, at least. And the figure is pretty nicely done. And I really love the green and blonde highlights in his hair. And it's just a nice figure overall. Number 8 is Grima Wormtongue from Lord of the Rings. Now, Grima is kind of, he was always in the movies, kind of bounced back from, you know, the good guys to the bad guys, but I think in the end he was kind of bad. But the figure, I always wanted this figure for a long time, and I really like this figure. Recently, he did come with a handkerchief, which broke off his finger, but that's okay. It looks fine without it off. But the detail on him is pretty nice. I think the face swap to Brad Dourif is pretty nicely done. You know, he's layered. I love the dragging effect, obviously, but I also like it when figures layer with cloaks and capes and stuff. I really love that effect. And the detail, just overall, I like his, you know, fur here. It's just pretty nicely done. So there he is. Number 7 is the Movie Heroes Wave 3 Light Up Lightsaber Darth Vader. This is one of my favorite Darth Vader figures. Obviously, he can light up his lightsaber, which is pretty cool, but I just love it. It's not because of that. The detail on him, I think it's one of the best-looking Darth Vader figures, of course, in my opinion. I love the cape detail. I think this cape is really nicely detailed and one of the best detailed capes there. And it's not too long, not too short, so it's pretty nice, in my opinion. Number 6 is the Friday the 13th Pamela Voorhees figure. She came in the Friday the 13th 25th anniversary box set, and I really liked the figure. I remember really wanting the set for the longest time, like 3 years or something, and I finally got it for like $15 on eBay, and I was really happy. And although I do really wish they would update Pamela in, you know, the NECA line, or stuff like they did with the Jasons and stuff. This is still a really nice figure. The likeness is good, not the best, but it's pretty good. The detail on her shirt is nicely done. She comes with a knife, and she did come with a few other weapons, but obviously I think the knife is her most iconic weapon, and it's just really overall nicely done figure. So there's that. Number four, I think I messed up, but we're on number four. It's the Dark Knight Movie Masters Ra's al Ghul. Again, you know, this is pretty much, his body is pretty much reused of, you know, the Gotham City Thug and Two-Face and Scarecrow, stuff like that. But I really like this figure, and again, this is a figure I've really wanted for a long time. And, you know, this year I was able to get him. And, you know, his face sculpt is okay. Let me just get this mask off. Oops. Sorry about that. His face sculpt is okay. It is a pretty good likeness to Liam Neeson, but I don't really care too much for the, you know, open mouth. But what I really think makes this figure sinister and menacing is the mask. I think he looks really menacing with the mask on. So if you have this figure, which I think a lot of people do by now, you know, I definitely prefer to leave the mask on, and I recommend that too. But I do really like his glove, you know, gloves there, so he's a pretty cool Batman figure. And number three is, this figure has actually been repacked multiple times, but it is NECA Michael Myers figure. I got mine on a single card, NECA Cult Classics Hall of Fame or something like that, that he just came with his knife and a pumpkin, and that's it. And that did it for me. Of course, I do want the other versions, but this figure is pretty, you know, hard to come by now in all versions. Even this one goes for a pretty penny on line, but the detail on him is pretty nicely done on his mechanics too. I talked about this figure many times. The face sculpt is pretty nice done. Knife is very big, but still pretty cool. And overall, just nice. And hair is nice too. So there he is. And number two is another horror figure, and it is Friday the 13th Part 4. Mezco Jason Voorhees. Probably one of my favorite Jason figures I have. I just think, you know, you can take his mask off. The detail on him is awesome. I do want the NECA ones, but from what they look like, it pretty much looks like they're just repaints of the Part 3 NECA ones. But the face sculpt is pretty gruesome, and it's pretty awesome. But I really like it. He comes with a bunch of accessories. Of course, I have him with his machete. The detail is pretty nicely done on him. You can see all the fold wrinkles, the blood stains. Just overall, pretty nicely done figure. So there is number two. Now, of course, I do love all of my villain figures. I love every action figure I have, because if I didn't love it, I probably wouldn't buy it. Even though I am somewhat of a completist in ways. So sometimes I just like to complete, you know, series of figures just to have them all. But this figure is really cool, and is number one is Lord of the Rings Saruman. Saruman is my favorite Lord of the Rings character, with, you know, Arwen and Elwyn being third and second and third. But he has always been my favorite Lord of the Rings character, and he's an awesome villain. And the figure is just awesome. I think the face sculpt is pretty good to Christopher Lee, and overall, just really nicely done figure. Of course, he has a gimmick, like most of the, you know, figures did, you know, in that line, but, you know, it's not a bad gimmick, actually. But the detail, I just love his hands. I think his hands are very nicely detailed, the veins and nails. He comes with pretty cool accessories, his plantier here. You know, his plantier is kind of plain, but oh well. And his iconic staff, of course. So that is number one. I do have some honorable mentions I really want to, you know, mention, because these figures I did want to put on the list too. The third honorable mention is this Darth Vader figure. He came in the concept line for Power of the Force, but for a display Vader, he's pretty nicely done. I think he's my favorite A New Hope Vader I actually have, and I think he is really awesome and really nice mask too for Power of the Force, and he makes a great display piece. Not for articulation, I think, or anything. Number three is a tie between these two figures because they are in the same outfit, and it is the Vintage Collection and Mission Series Darth Sidious's. I really do like both, but I think I do like the Mission Series one a little bit better, but both are very nicely done, detailed, and both have really cool accessories and just are overall really nicely cool. Number two honorable mention is the DC Universe Joker. I think, honestly, he's the best comic book Joker figure there is, in my opinion. He's really nicely detailed. Comes with gray accessory. Looks like he popped out of the comic books. And he just overall looks really nicely done and has good articulation, too. And number one honorable mention is the NECA Friday the 13th Part 3 Battle Damage Jason. Again, pretty cool, detailed Jason. One reason I really like this figure is because of the awesome face sculpt under that mask. He looks just like he did from the movie. It's really cool. Comes with, again, awesome weapons. You can get that axe effect, right there. Like that. And he's overall just really nicely done, and the detail, again, is pretty nicely done. So that is my top 15 plus 4 honorable, or 3 honorable mentions villain figures. Thanks for watching. Remember, if you have any requests or ideas for videos, let me know. And thanks for watching. Until next time, have a great day. Please subscribe to my channel. Bye.